I learned drawing canvases. I was drawing paper, painting canvases from when I was very, very little back in school. It's back then it was easy, my school was very academic, so normally we would be told what we want to draw. We would go like, "Well, that's a head of Socrates. Now you're gonna draw this for the next 3 weeks. Now draw a figurative composition with four persons," and so that sort of thing. You don't have to think much. It's you're given a canvas and you have to do the job. After I graduated, it kind of, it started making sense when you have an empty canvas and you have to figure out what's gonna be like. It's absolutely different. So I don't know, ever since I got away from school, I didn't go back much to a canvas or a paper because I just was so sick of it. I was looking for objects, making installations, paintings on found objects, and I don't know, just copy paste everything. Mix and mash things together, and then that was kind of as well, which something which led me to work in the street, which I found it comfortable on working on random surfaces and random locations and sizes every time with every piece. Which one I prefer, I still don't know. It's as I see it, for me, it challenges kind of, different sides of a brain. When you have empty canvas, you have to come up with a story and the stuff which is gonna look like, and you have something which is, as a location or a wall or an object which already suggests you something. Then you have a completely different approach. I still enjoy working on both. It's just very different experience, and the variety of experiences is something I really look to when doing my arts. I try to challenge myself with every artwork, so I swap around from canvas to objects to streets, back to canvas, and from medium to medium, just to keep myself interested and entertained.